Aguten. Sebat tun takap skaus. Nelim mas alida of abas ro kult asis. They were playing a game. They had to pick up blocks using an elastic band and four bits of string. We must all keep the tension the same. They took so full together. The couple carefully placed the elastic band around the block and picked it up. They had to make a tower of six blocks. The first team to build one was the winner. Just as they were about to place the last block on their tower, it toppled over. Ah, well, we came in last, said Nedim. It is thinking back that counts, said Will, but I still wanted to win. The cup pack leader, Akela, calls the pack together. Tonight is special, he said. We are going to invest with and Chip, and they are going to make their cup scout promise. Chip and Will had learned the promise of by heart, but Chip was still nervous in case he had forgotten it. Then they said it together. The promise was about helping other people and keeping the cup scout low. What is the cup scout law? Asked Dad. That's easy, said Job. Cup scouts always do their best. Think of others before themselves and do a good turn every day. Say that. A good turn. How about tidying your room? Said Dad. That would be a good turn. No, said Chip. I would only be helping myself. That wouldn't count. You could give us all a sweet, so good Wolf. That wouldn't count either, said Chip. Or Nedim could do this worksheet for me, said Kipa. He's good at number facts. No, said Jeff. You wouldn't learn anything. Don't forget, we promised Akela we'd find out more about the scouts, said Jeff. Lord Baden Powell set up the scouts, said Nedim. The first scout camp was on Bronzy Island in 1907. That's a start. Let's find out more about Baden Powell, too, said Wolf. Let's look on the internet, said Chip. The laptop was in Wolf's room. It was on her bed with the magic key next to it. Suddenly, the key began to glow. The key might do us a good turn, said Chip, and take us to meet Baden Powell. The magic took the boys back in time to Bronzy Island. See those things, said Chip. I bet this is the first scout camp. Well, said Wolf, if we do meet Baden Powell, we won't be able to tell Akela. That must be a bell tent, said Nedim. It has only one pole and isn't in the middle. But where are Baden Powell and all the boys? Asked Chip. The tents were made of thick canvas. The boys could see a fire with a large cooking pot over it. Steam was curling up from the pot. Nearby was a table with plates and boards and pans on it. The Come look at these artists. In one of the tents, three boys were peeling potatoes. One of the boys came out and picked up a box of carrots. He took them back inside. "Let's leave them to eat," said Jeff. "They might make us help them peel the carrots." "I suppose it would be our good turn if we did," laughed Wilf. At that moment, they heard voices in the distance. They set off to find out where the voices were coming from. In a hollow beyond some trees, they saw a group of five boys, all about 13 years old. The boys were arguing about something. The boys had two poles and coils of rope, but they all seemed puzzled when they saw Chip and Nedim. One of them asked, "How did you get here? This island is private." "Private. Are you doing a team exercise?" asked Nedim. "Yeah," another boy said. "But we've no time to chat. Mr. Baden-Powell has set us a problem, but we can't solve it." "What sort of problem?" asked Wilf. "Between these blanks is an imaginary river," the boy said. "We have to find a way to get over it, but these poles don't reach across. They're too short to make a bridge. We get points if we can cross the river without falling in." Chip looked at Nedim. "We are good at solving problems," he said. "Said Nedim. "There may be a way to do it." "What do you mean?" asked the wolf. Nedim asked the boys to tie one pole horizontally so that it hung from the other. "Now use the ropes to hold the first pole upright," he said. Nedim stood on the horizontal pole and used his weight to make it swing in a circle. "It could work," shouted one of the boys. "You're a genius." They placed the upright pole in the center of the imaginary river with the horizontal pole on the bank. The first boy edged along the pole to reach the ball in the middle. He swung the horizontal pole round, then carefully moved along it to the opposite bank. As each boy crossed the river, a rope was thrown to the other side to keep the middle pole steady. The boys cheered when they were all crossed. A man had been watching the exercise as the last boy crossed. He called, "Well done, Ravens. You are the only patrol to do it," submitted Nedim. "I think that's Lord Baden-Powell," he said. The man frowned. He was about to ask Chip, Viv and Nedim who they were when a boy ran up in a panic. "Alex has cut his finger chopping carrots," he panted. "We can't find the first aid kit." They ran to the conveyor belt, looking at a large tin chest. "You've got a fresh ticket somewhere," he said. "Where is it?" Chip had some plaster in his pocket. "It isn't not a deep cut," said Chip. "Put this plaster on it." "Plaster? What is that?" said Alex. "Cubs sometimes carry a simple first aid kit," said Chip. "It is best to be prepared." Madam Powell looked up from the chest. "How did you boys get to the island?" he asked. But the key had glowed, and Chip and Madam had vanished. "Be prepared," he said. "Well, we kept the Cub Scout low. We did a good turn," said Madam. "But if we do a good turn on a magic adventure, we can't tell anyone," said Wolf thoughtfully. Just then, Biff and Chip came in. Biff and Juma came in. "We've been on an adventure and met Madam Paul," said Chip. "Madam solved a problem, and I put a plaster on her cut finger. So we did two good turns." "Putting a plaster on a cut isn't much of a good turn," said Biff. "At least I had a plaster. I was prepared," said Chip. "But if we do good turns on magic adventures and no one knows, do they count?" said Wolf. "Of course," said Biff. "A good turn is a good turn." We found out less about the scouts and met Baden Powell, but we didn't find out his first name," said Madam. "Easy," said Wilma. "It is Robert. I can't think of a motto of magic event for magic adventures." "Love it, Chip. Be prepared for anything." The end.